إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. وبعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى in the Quran said in a very straightforward way، وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، that surely we are not created, that our purpose, our sole purpose of existence in this life is for nothing except to fulfill the purpose of ubudiyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Human beings in this life are journeying. It's a journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. But surely humans are striving for different things. And it varies. Some are striving for taqwa and nearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some are striving for very different things. But in the journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even among the believers, those who want to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oftentimes we encounter problems. Oftentimes you will find people that will tell you, you know what, it is so hard. I've been trying and trying, but that's what they say. I keep failing and I keep failing and I'm ready to give up. I can't take this anymore. We see that sometimes. You see people going towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a year and two and mashallah, but after a while something happens and they go back and they fumble and they can't stand up again. Others, they just stand still. There are no fruits. I've been praying, I've been fasting Ramadan for years and years, but I feel I'm stand still, I'm not moving. What's going on? Why? Today inshallah, I intend by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to speak about manzilat al-qawm al-a'zam, the greatest station of the people who seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The station by which you enter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so fast. The cure of what I just said. For surely this has been the problems of human beings long time ago. It's even narrated that, I'll start with this story, even narrated that long time ago when people used to travel in caravans, there was this man who was traveling in a business caravan to do some business. And back in the day, it took some time to travel. Please come forward. And it took some time to travel. And he traveled and he's doing his business, and finally he's coming back home in the caravan. And you can imagine his state now, eager to see his family. He made money, he's happy. It took months to do that. But on the journey back, all of the sudden thieves, if you will, bandits, raided the caravan. And he had to see those thieves coming down and now taking all his money, taking all his things and raiding them and taking everything away from them. But it didn't end there. As he was sitting, watching them dividing the spoils, you take this, you take that, you take that. And their sheaf is in the middle. Then they took the food of the people too. And they started, you know what, let's eat. And he's watching those bandits, those thieves, sitting together, dividing the food and sharing and eating. But he noticed something. Their chief, their leader, the big boss if you will, instead of sitting with them, he went far away and didn't eat with them. So he said, why? Like they did what they did, why is he not eating? He said, let me go ask him. So he went politely to this person, asked him, excuse me, why aren't you eating with the rest of them? I mean, do you feel haughty? What's going on? Why aren't you eating? And the chief of the bandits looked at him and told him, because I'm fasting. Fasting? Fasting? Can you imagine the state of the man? You're a thief, you raided a caravan. What are you doing? Fasting? Fasting? While you're raiding people's caravan? What's this? The chief of the bandits looked at him directly and told him one statement. A door that I keep open. A door that I keep open. A door that I keep open. And then went away, gathered all his thieves and all his like followers, and they just went away. And now you can imagine the state of this person. What's that person stealing while fasting? And you can imagine probably what he did. He probably spoke to this everywhere, told everyone about this thief who's fasting and stealing people at the same time. What a ridiculous thing. It wasn't till years later where this same man was in Mecca, around the Kaaba, maybe doing Umrah. And then he says, while doing my Umrah, I look and there is this man there in such a state of tawbah and dua and repentance. He is in such a state of inaba to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so close to him that I felt I want to be near him. He's making beautiful dua. He's in ibadah. It's beautiful. And as he's going near this man, he says, I know you. I know you were the chief of those bandits that years ago raided Mike. What happened to you? What changed you? How are you like this? How did you change? And he looked to him and he told him one sentence again. Didn't you know that whomever leaves a door between him and the All Merciful, that the Most Generous will one day enter unto him from this door? What do we learn from this? A door that he left open. What do we learn from this? The month of Ramadan is coming. I fasted, alhamdulillah, so many months, but I want to be like this person. I want the state of tawbah, of inaba. What did he do? Fasting? He was fasting, but what was it? What was the action, if you will, that he did that brought him so fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What was it? I'll tell you one that's very relevant, and it is what we're speaking about today. Sidq, truthfulness. Sidq. He was truthful. When we speak about truthfulness, the first thing that comes to my mind is what? Truthfulness of the tongue. Say the truth. I'm speaking about something more. Yes, there is truthfulness of the tongue. But me, a human being, I'm not just a tongue, am I? No. The most important organ in me is not my tongue. It's my heart, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet told us. It's my heart. This organ that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at. I'm speaking about, as scholars define, truthfulness as an act of the heart. Truthfulness of the heart. Sidq. This man wanted to repent. Was truthful in his wanting to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He had truthfulness in that. He didn't lie to himself. He was truthful to himself. I'm doing something wrong. I need to get out of here. He didn't seek excuses. No. He had sidq in his raja', his hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was truthful in that. His truthfulness is in resolve. As such, scholars will define truthful as follows. The definition given by Imam al-Harawi, Shaykh al-Khurasan, متوفي 481 هجري. He defined sidq, if you will, as follows. حصول الشيء وتمامه وكمال قوته واجتماع أجزائه كأن يقال صادق في توبته صادق في توكله صادق في صبره. He defined sidq, the thing that we're speaking about is when something becomes complete, perfect, it attains all its part. Like what you say, truthfulness is in his love. He's truthful in his love. He's truthful in his patience. Sidq is such an important quality, it enters into everything else. A person who's having reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is sidq in reliance. Truthful in my reliance. Truthful in my patience. Truthful in my seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is truthfulness as we speak about it. And further, they went further and Ibn al-Qayyim states the following. كمال العزم وقوة الإرادة بأن يكون في القلب ساعية صادقة إلى السلوك وميل شديد يقهر السر على صحة التوجه فهو طلب لا يمازجه فطور ولا يكون فيه قسمة بحال. A translation roughly, it's a complete resolve, strong want, desire, by which the heart will have strong, truthful drive to seek and walk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A strong inclination that overcomes oneself and forces him to continuously seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sidq, truthfulness. Oftentimes this is our problem. I say, I want to memorize Quran. Really? Truly? I want to be praying Qiyam al-Layl. Do you have sidq? Really? We know it. If you're a student and you want to get your PhD, sometimes we have truthfulness in that. I'll go to the university. I'll spend the night in the library. Right? I'm willing to give 4 years to get my degree. I have sidq in that intent. When I say, I want to get closer to Allah, I want to memorize Quran, the problem is, there is no truthfulness in there. I say it, but in reality, I don't really mean it. Sidq is lacking. Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, and observed a person who's like many of us, you know, praying, and he told him, Ya Ghulam, مالي أراك في طول قيام وسهر وتعب ونصب وقلبك لا يبرح من مكانه. أصدق الله فقد أغناك عن كثير من التعب. Oh my son, why do I see you standing prayer and exhausted in effort and effort like many of us, but your heart does not move forward from its place? And then he told him, أصدق الله, have truthfulness, صدق in Allah. It will relieve you from lots of agonies and tiresome. You don't need to be doing all this. You need صدق. Bilal radiallahu anhu, there was a race once. And one person came and asked, من سبق? Who won? Who came first? Asking about the horses. Bilal radiallahu anhu, and his words were few. He looked to him, and we know who Bilal is. He told him, الذي صدق. The one who was truthful. He's the one that comes first. And the man told him, I'm asking about the horses. أسألك عن الخير. وأنا أدلك على الخير. Bilal responded, and I'm telling you about what's good. صدق. Truthfulness. صدق. What drives me? What's my intention? What am I seeking? What do I want? صدق القصد. صدق الإرادة. Wanting. I want something in this life. Think about it and be truthful with yourself. What do I want? You know the problem, many of us, they don't want anything. They wait for the society to tell them what they want. They live according to the society, to their parents, to their children. Some of us want stuff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran speaks about this word irada. Irada. And tells us, amazingly, tells us shaitan, be careful, shaitan has irada. He wants something. Right? وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُضِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. Shaitan wants to misguide you. Wants animosity between you. As the Quran indicates. Then it goes to the human being and says, as for the human being, بَلْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنسَانِ لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَهُ. Some of us, what they really want is to continue living their life in whatever way they want. They don't want any rules. Sometimes it says it's different. Some human beings, مِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرِيدُ الدُّنْيَا وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرِيدُ الْآخِرَةِ. Some of you want the resolve, their desire is really this world. Some, it's the hereafter. But more amazingly than this, how do scholars define irada then? And you look to it, مدارج السالكين, for example, it tells you منزلة الإرادة, the station of want, desire, and صدق الإرادة, هي التجرد من الإرادة. To have no desire and will from yourself. What does that mean? أريد, look at this statement, أريد ألا أريد إلا ما يريد. I want what I really want is not to want anything from myself. I want not to want except what Allah wants. I want to be in a state that whatever Allah wants becomes what I want. My happiness is His happiness. What I see good is what He sees good. I want to see that me, I'm by Him. أريد ألا أريد إلا ما يريد. And therefore the first step of a مريد هي إسقاط إرادته. إرادة الله بإسقاط إرادته. I realize this. It is not about me. I want Allah. I want to want what He wants. I want to be driven not by myself, not by people, by Him, for Him, in Him. صدق الإرادة. This is what we're speaking about. What does Allah want then? For us to wish. What does Allah say in the Quran? Did He tell us what He wants? Yes, He did. And look at this. Some of us want this life. Want to be away from Allah. I don't want to pray. I want to go have fun. Right? And I'm happy with that. But Allah, Rabbil Alameen, the one that created the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them, what does He want? Look at this. وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَن تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ. خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Allah wants tawbah for you, to grant you tawbah, repentance. Tawbah means to come back. He wants you near Him. Can you imagine? Allah wants me personally. This is what He wants. I want you close to me. Wallahu yuridu an yatuba alaykum. But people of desires, they want you to go astray. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ. Allah wants to make things easy for you, not hard. He's not intending hardship. لَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرِ وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. For the human is weak. He wants you close to Him. His happiness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy Yes, as in the hadith. We know the hadith. Lallahu afrah. What makes Allah, what makes me happy? Think about it. Being away from Allah. What makes Allah happy? Lallahu afrah bitawbati ahadikum. Allah's, what makes Allah so happy is when some of us actually doing bad things repent and turns back to Him. He's so happy with this. He's happy with me near Him. Yet I'm not happy being close to Him. What's wrong with my irada? What's wrong? Do I have sitq in me? Am I seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is why we fail. As in a hadith, and think about this hadith please. It's reported in Sahih al-Nasa'i about an A'rabi that came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he believed. And he went with him. And they were in an expedition. Right? And after fighting and everything, they divided the spoils of war. And the Prophet gave him, like, here is your share. And he said, مَا هَذَا? What's this? مَا عَلَى هَذَا تَبِعْتُ? I didn't follow you for this. إِنَّمَا تَبِعْتُكْ لِأُضْرَبُ بُسَهْمٍ هَا هُنَا. I followed you in this so that I will be shot with an arrow right here. So I will die. Have shahada. Not for this. And meet Allah like that. What did the Prophet tell him? أُصْدُقِ اللَّهِ يَصْدُقْ. If you leave with anything today, I want it to be the statement. أُصْدُقِ اللَّهَ يَصْدُقْ. Be truthful with Allah. And He will make it happen. He'll be truthful to you. It will happen. And later on, they were fighting again. And some people of the companions came to the Prophet and said, look, look. And they found the same man with an arrow right where he pointed. The Prophet said, أَهُوَ هُوَ? Is he the one? Is he the one? He said, yes. He said, صدق الله فصدقه الله. He was truthful with Allah. So Allah was truthful to him. I want to memorize Quran. أصدق الله يصدق. I want to get closer to Allah. أصدق الله يصدق. أصدق الله يصدق. This is why scholars would say, one of our dua, اللهم ارزقني الصدق في الطلب. Oh Allah, please grant me, provide me truthfulness in seeking you. I ask you to say this dua. It's a good time to stop and make dua. Please make this dua to Allah to grant me and you truthfulness in seeking Him. Please also don't forget Sheikh Muhammad Faqih and his twins from your dua. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. It's narrated once that Imam Malik, the people approached him and they told him, you know what, people have so many slaves. We want you in the khutbah to tell people, you know, free your slaves, make a khutbah about it. So people would free their slaves. And Imam Malik went up on Friday, gave the khutbah, nothing. Did not speak about the issue whatsoever. People said, maybe he forgot. Next time, next week, he came up, nothing. Didn't speak about the issue whatsoever. Yeah, what's going on? Third week, he went up and he gave a khutbah. And at the end of his khutbah, before going down and making dua, he looked to the people and said, oh people, please free your slaves. And it is said, once he went down and finished salah, people were freeing slaves left and right. Everyone was free. People was like, how? What went on? Ya Imam, what we asked you 3 weeks ago and you didn't do anything. And one statement like this, and what happened? And he said, when you asked me to free slaves, I didn't have any slaves of my own. So I waited and I had to work and save some money first. Then I bought a slave. Then I freed the slave. Then I went up and told people to free the slave. Sidq. See his truthfulness? With truthfulness, one sentence. Me, look at me. Look at your khatib today. Speaking about truthfulness. 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 50 minutes. Imam Malik, one sentence. People would be doing it. We lack sidq. أصدق الله يصدق. What's the difference between truthfulness and sincerity? We know about sincerity, don't we? الرياء. Right? We know people tell you be sincere, ikhlas. Is there a difference between ikhlas and sidq? Is there? As scholars say, yes, there is. Very interesting. They say the following: al-ikhlas huwa at-tanaqqi min mutala'at al-khalq. Ikhlas, sincerity, sincere, is to be free from people watching you. The fact that, you know, showing off because they're watching, I will do something. That has to do with ikhlas. Was-sidq at-tawaqqi min mutala'at al-nafs. And truthfulness is to be careful from your own nafs. فالمخلص لا رياء له. A sincere person has no riya, doesn't show up. والصادق لا عجب له. But for this person with truthfulness, صدق, has no conceitness, no self-admiration. What does that mean? Well, interestingly enough, you might do something and you think it's sincere. For example, let's say yesterday I went and I said, let's pray by night. Nobody sees, right? Ikhlas. And you sat down and like, Allahu Akbar, and it was so good. Excellent. Right? So now, alhamdulillah, my intention, I guarded my intention in the beginning. I was sincere, nobody sees. But guess what happened? What happens after the deed is done? As Abu Madian says, قَدْ تَسْتَوْلِ النَّفْسُ عَلَى الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحِ فَتُصَيِّرْهُ جُنْدًا لَهَا فَتَصُولُ بِهِ وَتَطْغَى فَتَرَى الرَّجُلْ أَزْهَدْ مَا يَكُونَ أَطْوَعْ مَا يَكُونَ وَهُوَ عَنِ اللَّهِ أَبْعَدْ مَا يَكُونَ. After doing the deed, the nafs will grab the deed. تَصُولُ بِهِ وَتَطْغَى. What? See those two rak'ahs? What? I became a abid. Look at me. I read the Quran. I read three juz yesterday. You might not even tell people about it, but the nafs grabs the deed. And as such, brags with it and sees itself higher than others. Self-admiration. Look at me. Look at what I did. As if I did it from my own. Ujb, self-admiration. Being careful that I'm not doing anything for the sake of people. Ikhlas. But I should not be doing stuff for me. It's for Allah. No share for myself. That's what happens. Sometimes Ramadan is coming, Taraweeh, right? You go and pray. And the person might be sincere in the beginning. He prays and he has such a beautiful experience. The imam is excellent. Next year he goes to the same masjid. Why? Now I'm going because the imam was good. Because I enjoyed it so much last year, I'm going so that I will enjoy it again. I'm going now for who? Not for people. But it's for me. Because it was so sweet. I'm seeking the state. And if he finds the imam is gone, what happens? He leaves. I prayed yesterday, qiyam. It was so beautiful. Today I stand, Allahu Akbar, nothing. No hal, no state. Many of us would do what? Drop the ibadah. Lack of sidq. Lack of sidq. What illustrates this in a very clear way, there is a hadith, and it's in Bukhari, narrated by Abu Huraira. And may Allah forgive me for my weak translation of it, with the meaning of, there was one man once, and he said, لا أتصدقنا بصدقة. I want to give charity. Right? He wants to give charity. He wants to go and do the good deed. He went by night. Nobody sees. Right? Ikhlas. And then he went by night, gave the charity to someone, ran back home. He wakes up next day and he finds the entire town mocking and making fun. What are they saying? تصدق على سارق. Didn't you see what happened yesterday? Somebody gave a charity to a thief. So what does the man say? He says the following. سارق. اللهم لك الحمد. A thief. Oh Allah, all praise and thanks be to you. لا تصدقن الليلة. I'm going to repeat it again. I'm going tonight to do the same thing. He goes out. Here is person. He gives him charity. Her goes back. Nobody sees. Ikhlas. Next day he wakes up and the entire town is mocking. تصدق على بغي. Yesterday, didn't you see this man, this crazy man? He came again tonight and he gave money to a prostitute. Can you believe that? He's giving charity. The entire town is speaking. He says, بغي. يا اللهم لك الحمد. Oh Allah, لك الحمد for that. لا تصدقن الليلة. Again. And he goes again. And find someone, gives him money, runs back to find out the next morning, the entire town for the third time. It's not like news, right? Watching what this man is going to do next. Everyone is like mocking him. تصدق على غني. Can you believe somebody gave charity to a rich person? What a fool, right? You know what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed that what? تقبلت صدقتك. Your charity has been accepted. There is a purpose behind that. As for the sariq, as for the thief, this charity might make him stop and think and stop stealing and turn back to Allah. As for the woman, this charity would suffice her and she would think and stop and turn back to Allah. As for the ghani, the rich person, when you give him charity, it wakes him up. People are giving charity, might he give charity of his own? What do we learn from this? There are so many lessons. You see him, sidq. Many of us would have ikhlas, but if you hear this, we get angry, we get upset. I try to help them and they mock me. Is this what I get? See the nafs now, see me? Me, I am being mocked? And what was his reward? Did he get any? He thought, what's happening? But he repeats on and on, doesn't stop. Sidq. Continuously, up and going. Sidq. Sidq talab. Right? But a bigger thing to think about. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing. There are many poor people outside. Right? This is a person with sidq and ikhlas. You would think that Allah would guide him to put the money to those who deserve it by my standard, which are who? The poor people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's definition is different. The poor people aren't the people that don't have money. The poor people are the people in disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give them, I want them back. You see this? Wallahu yuridu an yatub alaykum. Allah wants you back. That's why He's using the person with ikhlas and sidq to give the people who need more, the people who are far from Him, come back. See that? Brothers and sisters, ikhlas has to do with people. Sidq has to do with you. Ibn Mas'ud said in a statement, أشد الناس خسارة. The person who's losing the most. من شغلته الناس عن نفسي. A person who's people kept him preoccupied from his own self. He lives for people by people. They define for him his purpose and his intent in this life. He's afraid from the rejection. He tries to please. You can't please people. It's very hard. You will never please everyone. It's impossible. You please X, Y is angry. You please Z, your spouse is angry. You can't. You try, but it's very hard. You can't be driven by people and their pleasure and their fear. وأشد منه خسارة. And the person who's even more in loss than this person. من شغلته نفسه عن الله. Who's preoccupied by his own self from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not people. This is the problem of this society. Everything is about me. I don't care about anyone. It's me. I want to be happy. Me. Where is my share? Where is my happiness? I'm preoccupied, self-centered about me that I forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm seeking the purpose and drive of my life is my pleasure. That causes me to reject truthfulness and reject haqq. بَلْ جَاءَهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لِلْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ. That's why you hear many people, they seek the truth, they want Islam, and they ask you, is there any dating in Islam? No. I'm sorry, I can't be a Muslim. What are you saying? You're saying because the truth doesn't match what you want, you're not going to follow? Is that it? In many cases, that's it. That's what causes people not to follow the truth. They don't have truthfulness. Truthfulness, I see myself as lacking. I don't want me. I want what He wants. It's about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want Allah's pleasure. I want my pleasure to be His pleasure. I want my want to be His want. I want my happiness to be His happiness. This is sidq. في طلب الرضوان. People who are seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's satisfaction. And you think about this. What does it take to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy and pleased and to earn ridwan Allah? And look at this hadith عن عائشة رضي الله عنها. أم المؤمنين عائشة narrates, السواك مطهرة للفم وردوان للرب. سواك. سواك. A piece of food that you clean your teeth with is مطهرة للفم. Cleans your teeth and earns you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ridwan. Ya Allah, to earn your satisfaction, all what I need is what? $1, piece of food, suwak? That's what it takes. Look at me and you, what's stopping me? You learned this today, I learned this today. Why can't I get a suwak? Why? I don't like it. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ridwan, wa ridwanun min Allahi akbar. The biggest thing ever, bigger than Jannah. Allah's satisfaction, you earn with a suwak? Yet I don't do it. Allahumma rizuqni sidqa fi talab is the dua. You look to yourself and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, I'm weak. Allahumma inni du'aif faqawwi fi ridaka da'fi. Wa khudh ila al-khayr binasiyati waj'al al-islam muntaha ridai. Oh Allah, I'm weak. Make me strong in your satisfaction fi ridak. خذ بي, take with my forelock, take me, drag me to whatever good it is, and make Islam my utmost satisfaction. صدق في الطلب. Please, brothers and sisters, we're going to be making dua, but my intent, if you come up with anything today, أصدق الله يصدق. اللهم ارزقني الصدق في الطلب. اللهم ارزقنا الصدق في الطلب. اللهم ارزقنا الصدق في الطلب. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا, وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان, واجعلنا من الراشدين. اللهم رد أمة محمد إلى لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين, وأقم الصلاة.